The goal of this game is for children to put cards in order from least to greatest. This is the first game in a series of games that use the count and see cards. The unique thing about these cards is that on each card, the quantity of dots has a corresponding numeral above it, which helps reinforce the connection between quantities and written numerals. We'll start out using the 1 through 5 count and see cards, but you can add more cards as kids gain experience putting them in order. You can start by laying the cards out randomly on the table and asking, "What do you notice about these cards?" Children might say, "Oh, I see numbers." "Yeah, these are numbers, like the ones we see around the classroom and in books." "And what about these dots? Why do you think there are numbers above the dots?" And you can help children connect the number of dots to the numerals. If kids are just getting used to this idea, this conversation about the cards might be as far as you get. But otherwise, the next step is to ask the children to put the cards in order. So I'll say, "Can you put these cards in order from smallest to biggest?" See what you can notice while they do this. Do they lay out the cards from left to right? Do they start with one? Are they more focused on the numbers or the dots? Are they counting the dots, or can they recognize the quantities without counting? Do they know to leave space for the 3 card between the 2 and the 4? And even if children seem unsure or make a mistake, you don't need to correct them right away. Letting kids self-correct helps them to strengthen their number order skills. If they do seem stuck, you can ask questions like, "How did you decide where to put the 3? Or, "Can you count the dots on this card?" Knowing which number comes next and which one comes before is a fundamental early counting skill. Children often start learning about number order by reciting number words and learning the order of the words, 1, 2, 3. Then they start connecting quantities of objects, like 2 or 3 dots, to written numbers that represent those quantities, knowing that when they see 3 dots, it can be represented with the number 3. So watching kids put the cards in order not only helps you get a sense of where they are in their understanding of number order, but also how they're doing with number words, quantities, and written numerals. For an extra challenge, once the cards are in order, you can ask children to close their eyes while you remove one of the cards. See if they can figure out which card is missing, and then ask them, "How did you know which card I took out?"